I'm sure many of you must have asked yourself and wondered why Senior Prophet TB Joshua is the spiritual head of Synagogue Church of All Nations, SCORN. He is not part of PFN, neither is he part of Christian Association of Nigeria, CAN. These are bodies that are in charge of religious affairs, Christian religious affairs in Nigeria. PFN for Pentecostal, CAN for the general Christian denominations in Nigeria, but he's not part of any of them. Now, one would have asked, why? Is it doctrinal differences? Or is it personal differences? Or is it personality differences? Or is it methodological differences over how to do the Lord's work? Now, well, let us look at what could have, gone wrong here and there, and what would have brought about all of this. Like I say, there are a lot of denominations. If they call themselves Pentecostal, that's one part. Many of them have a specific way they go about their preachings, their, doctrines, and many of those things. Now, back then in the scriptures, among the apostles and people who call themselves Christians, they also have people who do not believe. There are what they call doctrinal controversy. These things do rise up. For example, they might say those that are not circumcised, and they emphasize on circumcision, that is for the Gentiles. If you're not circumcised, you cannot be part of Christ and all of those things. And these things happened in the early church. Doctrinal controversies arose as gospel spread from its Jewish origin to the Gentiles. In Jerusalem, the early church consisted mostly of Jews who had come to faith in Jesus as their crucified and risen Messiah. Although right there in Israel presently, 90% of them do not believe that Jesus Christ is Lord or is a Messiah. They call him son of a carpenter, trying to take the position of the Almighty God. But when the gospel spread north to Antioch and then beyond, through the first missionary journey of Paul and Barnabas, many Gentiles came to faith in Christ. If you want to check that, Acts 11, 20 to 21. After Paul and Barnabas returned to Antioch, some Jews called Judaizers, who professed to believe in Jesus, began going to the largely Gentile churches that Paul and Barnabas had established, teaching that in addition to believing in Christ for salvation, the Gentiles must also be circumcised and follow the Jewish ceremonial laws. Paul wrote a letter to the Galatians to refute their spiritually deadly error. Eventually, the Judaizers came to Antioch and were teaching Acts, were teaching, that is in Acts 15:11, saying, "Unless you are circumcised according to the customs of Moses, you cannot be saved." After Paul and Barnabas had great dissension with them, the church sent them and a delegation to Jerusalem to get this matter cleared up with the apostles and elders there. The Jerusalem Council affirmed the same gospel that Paul preached, but asked the Gentile converts to abstain from some things that will needlessly alienate unbelieving Jews. The point is that Paul didn't see this as an unimportant doctrinal dispute that should be overlooked in love. He saw it as poison water that threatened the truth of the gospel itself. Doctrinal differences are crucial when the truth of the gospel is at stake. Even though the Judaizers were probably sincere and only wanted to preserve the law of Moses, they were sincerely wrong. Paul didn't just shrug it off, saying, "Unity must prevail. Let's set aside our differences and come together where we agree." Rather, he fought vigorously for the truth of the gospel, pronouncing eternal judgment on these false teachers. That can be found in Galatians 1:6 to 9. He saw the people's eternal destinies were at stake. Correct doctrine can make an eternal difference. Now, that being said, just to let you know that there were doctrinal issues back in those days also. Now, let us look at what is really happening in Nigeria. What's really happening in Nigeria? Like I said, this question might have popped up in your mind. PFN, a Christian body of Pentecostal churches in Nigeria, and it is based on believing God with one's heart, and they believe in the Holy Spirit. They believe in the manifestation of the Spirit of power and all of that. Although some of them believe in speaking in tongues, like it is, of course, like I said, doctrinal issues. Some say no, you cannot. Like they stop you. They say if there is no interpreter If you want to speak in tongues, speak in your house. And there's always a day dedicated in some denomination where everyone in general speaks in tongue without having anyone to interpret, you know. So these things are there. Now, Papa, your researcher for the World of Life Church, who was the PFM president then, said that before TB Joshua can qualify to be PFM member, and even Daddy Adeboye is the leader of RCCG, he said the same thing too. He said he should show them who tutored him as a pastor or prophet in the first place. They claim that every one of them have a root, that it came from a root somewhere. It doesn't matter if it is white garment, if it is blue garment, red garment, Romaka. They all claim that it came from a root. But TB Joshua doesn't have a root. Where? How did you come about this, your healing, vision, prophetic gifts? Who tutored you? Which pastor did you serve under? Which church did you go to? All of these questions have not been answered by senior prophet TB Joshua, known also as Emitope Balogun, also known as Fatai. Like a lot of people said, he had a Muslim background, and there are a lot of mystery that shrouds him. In fact, I once met a friend who told me he claimed that his own mom from Ondo State taught TB Joshua in school. That is what he told me. And he said that TB Joshua had already started displaying some mysterious abilities then. Now, displaying mysterious ability does not necessarily mean that God gave you those abilities. Like, directly, do not forget that God created everything, even Lucifer. Lucifer does not have his own power at all. In fact, sin is greater than Lucifer. I'll break that down. If you could recall what happened in heaven, Lucifer was brought down by sin, meaning sin was stronger than Lucifer. And if you could also look into the scriptures a little bit, the Bible says, resist the devil, curse him, resist him, scream at him, you would flee. Just like how Jesus Christ rebuked him when he was trying to, you know, find a way to do the same thing he did in heaven, how he got some other stronger angels. A lot of people believe that Lucifer is stronger. No, physically, look, Lucifer wasn't built for war. Lucifer wasn't built for war. Lucifer was only built for beauty and very intelligent and cunning. Very intelligent. So he was closer to where the seat of the Heavenly Father Jehovah is. And along the line, he felt that he needed to become much more. And sin took over him. And he found a way to convert a huge percentage of angels in heaven. And he was able to sweet mouth them, hoping to create his own government, and was thrown down. And it is recorded in the Bible that the heavens say, woe unto the earth. So the battle that wasn't finished in heaven is the battle that is on earth. That's why people find a lot of very terrible things happening in the world. And people ask themselves, why? Why is all these things happening? Now, that being said, now I'm trying to buttress a point here. It's terrible. It's not a joke. It is terrible here. Now, having abilities does not necessarily mean that God gave you those abilities, as anyone can manifest any form of ability here and there. You could have gotten that energy from the devil to do his own bidding and acting like you are in Christ, like God knows you. So that's why I said that God created everything. Devil did not create anything. Sin, they say flee, not even from devil. They didn't say run away from devil. They say resist the devil. But they say sin, flee from sin, because sin is strong, sin is powerful. Sin brought down Lucifer himself. So that being said, God created everything. But that does not mean that anyone you see displaying some spiritual manifestations necessarily means that the person got the power from God. So that being said, he was asked, who tutored him? Where did he get any of these things from? How can we track and trace? And I asked myself, does that mean that we don't have pastors and prophets that are established who are not of God? And they would say, yes, this is my spiritual son. Does that mean that the person is from a source? Is this a criteria? Let us go deeper. There's no doubt that most Pentecostal pastors are not pleased with the way and manner TB Joshua runs his church. Not because everyone is also pleased with the way other Pentecostal churches are being run.
You see, they talked about his deliverance and many other things. Well, at least we've not seen him jumping on people like what we know. But there are certain things that have been reported by people who worked closely with him of the activities in TB Joshua's church. And these things also happen in other churches too. It's just that these things are being kept secret. A lot of terrible things happen in many churches. Prophets, spiritual sons sleeping with choirs and members and aborting children and doing a lot of things. People do not know that having a gift does not mean that you are in right line with God. Gift is in you, doesn't mean that you will go to heaven. So you can have gifts of healing. You can have probably to most of the time the popular one to be a seer and to see visions and to do all of these things. People do all of these things too. Doesn't mean that you are in right standing with God. And of course, DBS, marabous, they also have spiritual abilities to do many things that we see being done in churches today. So do not mistake these things together, that once someone sees visions or preaches or calls the name of Jesus Christ means that the person is from God. No, the person is not working for God. The person might be working for devil. So Iorisha Jaffa said, Jesus did not say by their words you will know them. He said by their fruits you shall know them. What are the fruits? He told TB Joshua to show him the pastor that tutored and pastored him before he said he was called into ministry, adding that he would be considered to join PFN if he can tell him when he got converted and how he got converted. According to him, he said salvation is a conscious decision one makes and it does not happen in one's mother's womb, as it was believed TB Joshua was converted in his mother's womb. How do you get conversion? How do you get born again? In the womb of your parents. You could come as a child of power. As they say, sometimes prophets are born, some are impacted into, and all of these things. Yes, these things are possible. You could come from your mother's womb, you could be called from your mother's womb, but still being called is having gift. It doesn't mean that you are now born again. When you now grow, you begin to grow in Christ and you receive salvation into yourself. Now with that, the Holy Spirit, you will be able to manifest that gift that you have inside of yourself, and a lot of things will happen. So, Papa Iorisha Jaffa added that if TB Joshua repents and is converted by accepting Jesus Christ as his Lord and personal Savior, then he's welcome to join PFN family. Now, people reacted to this. Of course, people say when one speaks, you will know where he's coming from. His level of understanding of things of God might be low. They said, who tutored and mentored Jesus Christ? Now, I want you guys that are deep in theology to go into this. Who mentored Jesus Christ? Was Jesus Christ mentored? Yes or no? Did Jesus Christ study? Did Jesus Christ take his time to go into the synagogue to study? Tell us about it. What about Prophet Elijah? What about John the Baptist? The Spirit from above is above all, said someone. Who is the man that pastored or mentored them? The Bible says that the children of God are taught by God. This is response from people. Now, someone said, does TB Joshua really need PFN or can to run a successful ministry? Someone said, what is special about these bodies themselves? Some say Nigerian pastors are full of hate and jealousy and they will do all when they see someone performing. Well, like I said, there are two major things. Having gifts and having the Holy Spirit. You could have gift without the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is what does the work. So some people might see vision. They might you know, do all of this spiritual connection. Does not mean that they have solutions. No, because the Holy Spirit is not inside of them, probably as a result of sin or some things. While some people were not called by God, they called themselves by getting themselves involved in some very occultic practices, and they use this to manifest. While some people are just fake. They have nothing to offer. They are just tricky, using tricks here and there, getting information from Facebook and trying to prophesy to people. While there are people who God called, like I said initially, who got out of hand, got out of the presence of God, and they need to still perform. They need people to still see. So they go to engage in diabolic powers so as to perform and to hear and to see. They do these things too. So I don't know what your thoughts are as regards this. Some have said a lot of things about TB Joshua. Not being part of PFN, do you think that's a problem? Do you think God called him or not?